Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So this video is HOA class 3. It's about Greek architecture. So in HOA class 1 we saw prehistoric and near east, and in class 2 we saw Egyptian architecture, right? So starting this video with Greek architecture. Greek architecture was classified into 3 periods. Okay, the first one was Aegean, second was Hellenic, and third one was Hellenistic, right? So Aegean was rough and massive. Hellenic was more about religious architecture. See the transition between rough and massive to more religious. Carpentry was used with marble, okay. Timber was imitated with stone with remarkable exactness. So stone was used to get form like timber, okay. The third period is Hellenistic, which is symmetrical and orderly with more matureness, rather to say. Its dignified and gracious structures were developed. So these were the 3 timelines: Aegean, Hellenistic and Hellenistic. Okay. So talking about the construction system, columnar and trabeated form was used. Okay, columnar and trabeated means nothing but a roof slab with columns supporting it. Okay. Like we saw hypostyle hall in Egyptian architecture. So roof truss appeared, enabling large spaces to unhindered by the columns. See, in Greek architecture, roof truss was just starting to appear, but roof truss was mainly developed during early Christian architecture. Okay, we will see about that in upcoming videos. So material used during Greek construction was timber, terracotta and stone. Okay. So going on further, let's talk about houses on mainland. Houses were mostly single storied house. Okay, it was a deep plan. The plan was lengthier. Columned entrance porch with central doorway. Okay, there was an entrance porch which was supported by columns. Living apartment proper with sleep room behind. So rather it was a lengthier column. In their plan, with columns supporting the entrance, there was living room with sleep room behind, right? So talking about tombs, tomb was rather rock cut or chamber, for example Tholos tomb. So as you can see in this cross section, there is a tomb which is rather a rock cut chamber, you should say. Okay, so this is treasury of Atreus at Mycenae. So we saw about materials, construction system, materials, and then we saw about houses and tomb. So here comes the main part of Greek architecture, which is temple. It is the chief building in Greek architecture. So as you can see, this is the basic form of what we can differentiate about. So starting with this triangular part is known as pediment. The decoration above this is known as acroterium. Okay, and the triangular part inside the pediment is known as tympanum, right? So this is entablature. This part is known as entablature. And then the base of the columns, where the columns meets the floor, it's known as stylobate. And the steps are known as stereobate. So these are the 5 basic parts of a temple: pediment, which is a triangular portion outside; tympanum is a triangular portion inside; acroterium is the small carving at the top. Leave entablature. The basic parts are stylobate, where the column meets the floor, and stereobate are the steps, right? So depending upon the number of columns and entrance, there are actually 11 types. For one column, it's known as hemostyle; 2 distyle; 3 tristyle; 4 tetrastyle, and so on up to 12 columns. Okay. So this was the basic form of how a Greek temple looks like. So talking about planning, naos is the main cell where the DT is placed. Okay. So a cell before the naos is known as pronaos. See, the word pro means before, okay? It is also known as anticum. And the cell after the central nous is known as epineus, okay? It is also known as posticum. So as soon as you enter the temple, you go to an anticum, then you visit the central nous and then posticum at the back, okay? So depending upon the columns at the front, they are differentiated into 11 types, okay? As you can see here. So we saw the general form of a Greek temple. So these are the moldings which were used in Greek temples, okay? Moldings, right? So for moldings, this is cyma recta with an S curve, cyma reversa with an inverted S curve, ovolo, this is a fillet curve, this is scavato, the C forming her. This is scotia and this is echinus. So there are seven moldings which were primarily used in Greek temples. There is cyma recta, cyma reversa, ovolo, fillet, cavato, scotia and echinus. So Greek temple was mainly known for its optical illusion. Okay. Certain refinements were used to correct optical illusion. Okay. So actually the Greek column was not perfectly straight, okay? It was slightly a convex curve, okay? This convexity of the columns is known as entasis, right? So going on further, this is about optical illusion. So how the optical illusion was corrected, okay? The temple stylobate where the column meets the floor, okay? An entablature with their curve emphasized. So their curve was a little bit emphasized. Okay. So if the optical refinements were not applied, it would look like this. So due to correct optical refinements, it is perfectly normal. And if it is exaggerated to be with more clarity, it would look like this. Okay. So the columns in Greek are slightly convex columns. Okay. It's known as entasis. So now talking about columns in detail, there are three main orders, okay? The first one is Doric order, which is more masculine in nature. Second is Ionic, which is more feminine in nature. And the third is Corinthian, okay? A composite of these both. So talking about the Doric order, see, as you can see, acroterium, which is the carving, okay? Then you can see the metope. Metope is nothing but this blank space, okay, between this triglyph. So here is a triglyph and this is another triglyph. The space between two triglyphs is known as metope. This is architrave, a simple architrave. The column's head is known as abacus. Its mid part is known as echinus and the bottom part is known as necking. So this column's top has abacus, echinus and necking. Okay, then comes the main shaft of the column, then the stylobate of the temple and stereobate. Stylobate and stereobate are together known as crepidoma. Okay, so remembering again, Doric is in masculine order with acroterium. Metope is between two triglyphs. Architrave is a basic one here. Column head has abacus, echinus and necking. Then comes stylobate and stereobate, together known as crepidoma. Okay. So then talking about Ionic order. Okay, Ionic is a more feminine order, right? So this is the pediment. And instead of acroterium, there is a raking cornice. As you can see this projection over here. It's raking cornice. Okay, the entablature consists of three parts: cornice, frieze and architrave. Okay, cornice, frieze and architrave, with frieze with couple of moldings. Okay, so these three together known as entablature. So the cornice is the top part, frieze is in mid and architrave is the bottom part of entablature. So for column head, it has abacus and volute. Volute is this carving, this round oval carving in the column head. Okay, so this abacus and volute are together known as capital, right? See, Doric order doesn't have any base. The column does not have any base, while Ionic order has the biggest base of these three. Okay, so remember, the column which has biggest base is feminine, that is Ionic order, right? So we saw Doric masculine, Ionic feminine, and talking about Corinthian order has dentils, which are small rectangular projections. So this capital is, since Corinthian is most decorative order, okay, it's most decorative order, so its column head has four parts, that is boss, as you can see these two rectangular projections, volute same as Ionic order, rosette, the part between volute and acanthus leaf, and acanthus leaf as an support to the capital. It's the bottom of the capital, right? So dentil, boss, volute, rosette and acanthus leaf. See the base. Talking about the base, Corinthian has a shorter base as compared to Ionic. Okay, so Ionic has the biggest base, Corinthian has a shorter base, while Doric does not have any base. So these were the three main orders of Greek architecture, that is Doric, Ionic and Corinthian. So talking about height of the orders, height is somewhat like this. So Corinthian is the tallest, then comes Ionic, and the shortest one is Doric. Okay, so this is the order of height. As you can see here, Doric is nothing but 4 or 6 into diameter of base. No base for a column, it's masculine order. Ionic is 9 times the diameter of base. Biggest base for a column, it's feminine. Biggest base, okay. Corinthian is 10 times the diameter of base, medium base, and most decorative order. Okay, so there are famous group of buildings in Greek. That is Propylae, Parthenon, Erechtheion. These are all situated at a near proximity. Okay, so remember in Greek, okay, in Greek there is Parthenon. Okay, and in Roman there is Pantheon. Okay, so don't get confused between these two. Okay, Pantheon, they're completely different. So Greek has Parthenon, Roman has Pantheon, okay? They two look absolutely similar to each other. So now we saw the three basic classification according to the timeline, okay? That is Aegean, Hellenic and Hellenistic. Then we saw construction system, that is columnar and trapeated. Materials like timber and terracotta stone. So houses were single storied with deep plan, column at the entrance, okay. Tomb was rock-cut tomb, and temples were classified according to number of columns at the front, okay. Then comes the general plan, where is anticum, naos and posticum, okay. Then comes the moldings which were used in temple, that is Ima, Recta, Reversa, Ovulo, Fillet, Cavatos, Cotia and Echinus, right? The columns are slightly convex, that property is called as entasis. And then we saw the three orders, that is Doric, Ionic and Corinthian, masculine, feminine and most decorative order, right? Then the last part about Greek architecture is its theater, okay, an open air theater which was developed during Greek architecture for many functions. So there are parts, I have labeled it as A, that is a proscenium stage, okay. So this A portion is known as proscenium stage. B is the wings of the proscenium, that is known as parasnia, okay. And the C is paradoi, entrance to orchestra. For entrance to orchestra, it's paradoi. Please remember these terms, okay? Proscenium, parascenia, paradoi. D is the entrance to spectators. Through this, spectators would enter the Greek theater. So it's D part. He is Cercidus, section of seating. So there are multiple sections, like 1, 2, 3. There are multiple sections in this open air theater. So it's known as Cercidus. F is Fodria, which is the seats of honor, like major people or people according to them, most important first class people would occupy the front row seats. Okay, so that portion is known as Poetria. Diazoma is a gangway. Okay, the gangways between these are known as diazomia. And H, the outer wall, is known as analemma. Okay, these red lines are gangways. Okay, G part, I missed it. So diazoma are gangways and H is analemma, that is the outer wall. Okay, so there are 8 portions. A, proscenium, that is the stage. B, parascenia, that's our wings. C is entrance to orchestra, that is paradoid. D is entrance to spectators. E is Cercidus, that are seating sections. Okay, there are seats around here, right? Okay, these are the seats. Okay, so that's how seats will be arranged. F is Prohydria, seats of honor. G is diazoma, those are gangways. And H is analemma, those are the outer wall. So that's all about Greek architecture. So we saw 3 classifications: Aegean, Hellenic and Hellenistic. We saw the construction materials. We saw how the house and tomb was developed. Then we saw a Greek temple, how they are classified. The basic parts, that is pediment, acroterium. Okay, then comes stylobate, stylobate, together known as crepidoma. Okay, the inner portion of pediment is known as tympanum. Okay, then we saw Doric, Ionic and Corinthian orders. Okay, the 3 basic orders for Greek architecture. There are 2 more, that's in Roman, that is Tuscan and composite. Okay, we'll see that during Roman. Okay, then we saw a Greek theater's ideal plan consisting of 8 parts: proscenium, that is the stage, parascenia, the wings, paradise, entrance to orchestra, entrance to spectators, the D part, Cercidus is seating. Okay, F, prohydria, is seats of honor. G, diazoma, is a gangway, while H, analemma, is the outer wall of the theater. Okay, I hope you understood this video. If you like my video, please hit the like button and please subscribe to my channel for more. Okay, so this was HOE class 3. Okay, we have completed 3 classes, so still plenty of timeline is yet to be covered. Okay, keep watching. Thank you. Take care. Bye bye.